Hey guys, Jake from 8020 Automotive. Today we're here to talk about P0700 transmission error codes. A P0700 error code is going to read out transmission control system, but that isn't actually referencing the transmission control module, also known as the TCM. Ultimately, a P0700 transmission control system means that you have an issue somewhere within your transmission. When you use a more generic, less expensive scan tool, you're typically accessing the engine control module or the ECM, and so you'll see all of the engine error codes or fault codes that appear on the ECM, but the ECM is separated from the transmission control module, and so we actually aren't able to see all of the error codes that are specific to the transmission. So in this case, what happens is there's an issue within the transmission, so the transmission control module then relays back to the engine control module, hey, we have a problem, and basically tells it to display a P0700 fault code, which then lets you know as the driver that, hey, you need to go ahead and take a look into the transmission or into the TCM to see what error codes the TCM is displaying. So ultimately, a P0700 could mean that you have issues anywhere throughout your transmission. It could mean that your clutch is starting to wear out, you've got bad shift solenoids or pressure control solenoids, you could be having issues with the valve body, you could be low or have dirty transmission fluid, you could have issues with your torque converter, you could have communication issues that actually are coming from the TCM. So ultimately, it could be anything within the transmission, whether that's just a basic sensor or whether it's an internal component of the transmission. It's very difficult to pinpoint what the specific problem is from just looking at the P0700 error code, and it makes no sense to try to jump in and start diagnosing this without reading into the TCM and seeing what error codes that gives you. So if a basic scan tool can't access the transmission control module to tell you what codes it's storing, the question is, how do we access the transmission control module? Like I mentioned earlier, when you use a scan tool, you're accessing the engine control module. Your basic $20 scan tool is not advanced enough or have the engineering and software in it to be able to read directly from the transmission. And the reason for that is because transmissions are not as standardized as the engine control module. Nowadays, all cars use OBD and specific CAN bus protocols that make them extremely standardized. But the transmissions are not as standardized. And so typically transmission codes and transmission error messaging is gonna differ on a manufacturer by manufacturer basis. Ford's is different than GM's, which is different than Stellantis and Mazda and so on and so forth. Ultimately, these lower, less expensive $20 scan tools just don't have all of the engineering in there to be able to have all the different protocols every manufacturer in there. To be able to read the TCM errors from any vehicle, you either need an advanced scan tool or you need the proper software and the proper hardware to access the TCM for your specific manufacturer. With respect to scan tools, there are some scan tools that are $80 or $100 that can read and access transmission control codes. And some of them go up to $400, $500, $800, $1,000, $1,500 plus dollars. And so ultimately, you just need one that is capable of reading transmission codes for your manufacturer. And so you might be able to find a good one out there for $80 or $100. But if not, I'm gonna go ahead and tell you about a couple common pieces of software for all these manufacturers that's usually either free to use or inexpensive to use and just requires a basic OBD to USB cable. For example, for Ford, the popular tool is called ForScan, F-O-R scan. For GM, we have ScanMaster or Torque Pro. For Stellantis, it's Alpha OBD. For Toyota, it's called TechStream. For Honda, it's iHDS. For Volkswagen and Audi, it is VCDS. For BMW, you have tools like Beamer Geeks or Pro Tool. And so those are just a handful of the vehicle-specific ones. For example, I have a Ford. I've done a video previously on reading transmission codes on a Ford. You just hook up the ForScan cable to their free piece of software, and it costs like $30 to do that, and then you can go ahead and read codes from the transmission control module, but also from a number of other modules like the body control module that you don't get access to through a traditional OBD scan tool. It is a really good idea to get a scan tool or a software and hardware combo that's capable of reading all of the different control modules within your car, just when it comes down to things like this, where you're trying to do more advanced diagnostics that aren't something that's purely engine related. So ultimately, when it comes to trying to diagnose a P0700 fault code, my recommendation is, one, make sure you've got enough transmission fluid in your transmission. Go ahead and check it for any leaks. See if there's any leaks coming from around the transmission that might indicate you're low on transmission fluid. If that's not the case, the second thing that you can try doing is trying to reset the code and see if it comes back up. You can either reset it with a scan tool, although that's not necessarily going to reset it inside the TCM. So the best thing to do here is to just go ahead and unhook your battery and leave your battery unhooked overnight. And that'll go ahead and reset all of the control modules in the vehicle. And then the third thing, if that doesn't work or if the code comes back, is to go ahead and get yourself a scan tool that's capable of reading transmission codes. And if you don't want to spend any money or buy one, you can go somewhere like an AutoZone, O'Reilly's, or Advanced Auto Parts, and they'll have an advanced scan tool there that you can hook up just to see what the code is. But ultimately, you're going to want to get into the TCM and see what code's coming from there, because that's really what's going to point you to what the problem is within your transmission system. Anyways, guys, I hope this video was somewhat helpful. Of course, if you have a P0700 code, you now have a little bit more hunting to do, but I hope this at least points you in the right direction so you're not chasing around all the different things that can cause a P0700 fault code. If you guys appreciate this video, please click the like button, subscribe to our channel, and stay tuned for all our future content.